Hello dear students, hope you are all doing good. Let us continue with the chapter Force and Laws of Motion, class 9th Physics. In the last video, we read about first law, momentum, inertia and types of inertia. Now let us discuss about Newton's second law of motion. Now to understand this better, consider a person who is applying some force on this mass, which means that initially the body is having some momentum written as P1 as mu. Suppose he applies some external force for some time T1. As you can see, if the force is applied, there is more acceleration, which means the speed increases faster. जिसका मतलब है वेलोसिटी चेंज हो जाएगी एंड इट विल बिकम वी एंड इफ द वेलोसिटी चेंजेस इट मींस द मोमेंटम आल्सो चेंजेस एंड इट बिकम्स एम वी अप टू सम टाइम T2 विच सिंपली मींस दैट एक्सटर्नल फोर्स इज ऑलवेज रिक्वायर्ड टू चेंज द मोमेंटम इन अ गिवन टाइम दिस इज व्हाट न्यूटन्स सेकंड लॉ इज द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ सेकंड लॉ ऑफ मोशन सेज दैट द चेंज इन मोमेंटम ऑफ अ बॉडी per unit time is directly proportional to the external force and the change in momentum always takes place in the direction of force which can be written as F external is equal to final momentum minus initial momentum upon change in time which can also be written as delta P by delta T and in some books you will see it is written as differential of momentum with respect to time which means when the time interval is very small then delta P by delta T changes to dP by dt. Newton's second law is the real law of motion which means we can derive third law and first law from the second law and also Newton's second law gives the measure of force yani Newton's second law se hame force measure karne ka ek formula milta hai which is F is equals to ma. Let us discuss how. Suppose you have a body. Now suppose a body of mass m is moving with some velocity u. Now some external force is applied over this body so that its momentum changes. So its initial momentum was mu, but if some force is applied, this body starts moving with some velocity v, and hence the final momentum becomes mv. Suppose initially the time t was 0, and when some force is applied, the time changes to t. So we can write the rate of change of momentum, yani time ke saath saath momentum kitna change hua, agar hum usko likhna chahein, to hum likhenge final momentum minus initial momentum upon final time minus initial time, which can be written as mv minus u upon t. If you remember the equations of motion, a is v minus u by t, as read in the chapter motion. So we can substitute over here, and according to Newton's second law statement, it is the external force which is responsible for the rate of change of momentum. So you can write it as mv minus u by t, and v minus u by t can be written as a, so we'll write it as ma, which means that force can be measured by a simple formula of mass into acceleration. And we can prove the first law from this simple statement, which says that if a body is moving with constant velocity, that means if v is equal to u, then the acceleration will also be zero. And you can write that the external force is also zero. Yani, agar koi body constant motion mein hai, to koi bhi external force usko नहीं चाहिए यानी अ बॉडी एट रेस्ट विल रिमेन एट रेस्ट और अ बॉडी इन मोशन विल रिमेन इन मोशन वो तभी अपनी मोशन चेंज करेगा जब बाहर से कोई एक्सटर्नल फोर्स लगेगी. नेक्स्ट वी हैव यूनिट्स ऑफ फोर्स. फोर्स को हम किस यूनिट में मेजर करते हैं? बिकॉज वी हैव ऑब्टेन्ड द फॉर्मूला ऑफ एफ इज इक्वल्स टू एम ए. इन एसआई सिस्टम मास इज मेजर्ड इन 1 kg or kg and acceleration is measured in meter per second square. So the SI unit of force is Newton.
You can define 1 Newton as when a force of 1 kg moves the body with an acceleration of 1 meter per second square, the force is said to be 1 Newton. And CGS system mein force ke unit hai dyne. That means 1 dyne can be defined as when body of 1 gram moves with an acceleration of 1 centimeter per second square, then the force is said to be 1 dyne. You can also derive the relation between Newton and dyne, and 1 Newton is always equal to 10 raised to power 5 dyne. Next we have applications of Newton's second law. We'll use only this formula and you can understand all the applications of Newton's second law in our daily life. A very common application is why a cricketer lowers his hands while catching a ball. Now you'll remember F is equal to delta P by delta T. हमें सिर्फ इतना याद रखना है कि अगर change in momentum का time impact बढ़ा दिया जाए, यानी जितना ज़्यादा time लगेगा momentum को change होने में, external force जो है वो उतनी ही कम feel होगी या external force जो है वो इतनी ही कम exert होगी. So when a cricketer lower his hands, वो क्या कर रहा है? वो time impact को बढ़ा रहा है जितनी देर में momentum change होगा. जिसकी वजह से उसके जो हाथ होंगे they'll be not hurt और they'll not be injured. Similarly, the second application is a person falling on a cemented floor. A person falling on a cemented floor gets hurt. Whereas, a person falling on a heap of sand is not injured. अब ऐसा क्यों होता है? Again, force becomes inverse to the time for the same change in momentum. तो जब एक person जो है cemented floor पे fall करेगा, तो rate of change of momentum will be very large because it will be abruptly stopped in a very small interval of time. Whereas, when a person falls on a heap of sand, the time interval will increase and he'll not get injured. Similarly, vehicles are provided with, as you can see in this image, vehicles जो होते हैं, they are provided with shockers. Trains are provided with buffers so that the time interval will increase. Similarly, another application is a karate player breaks the pile of tiles with a single blow. जो एक karate player है, can break the pile of tiles with a single break. Again, Newton's second law ki application, that when the time taken to strike the pile is very small, to kya hoga? Momentum jo hai wo ekdam se reduce ho jayega zero. So a very large force is exerted on the pile. So F is equal to again dp by dt. तो एकदम से मोमेंटम जीरो हो जाएगा और टाइम इंपैक्ट जो है वो एकदम सडन है, तो फोर्स एग्जर्टेड विल बी वेरी लार्ज एंड हेंस द टाइल और पाइल ऑफ टाइल्स कैन बी ब्रोकन. नेक्स्ट इज न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन. वेरी सिंपल एंड एप्लीकेबल लॉ जो हम अपनी रोज की लाइफ में देखते हैं. न्यूटन थर्ड लॉ सेज टू एवरी एक्शन देयर इज इक्वल एंड ऑपोजिट रिएक्शन. एक्शन and reaction are equal and opposite. Now if a book is placed on a table, तो जो book है वो table पे जो force लगा रही है उसको हम कहते हैं action, और table जो book पे force लगा रहा है उसको हम कहते हैं reaction. अब ये system equilibrium में क्यों है? Because the force exerted by the book is equal and opposite to the force exerted by the table, which means that the net force is zero. So we say that action and reaction में से जो पहली force है, यानी जो पहली body लगा रही है उसको कहा जाता है action, जो दूसरी body exert कर रही है उसको कहते हैं reaction. और ये दोनों एक दूसरे के साथ ही exist करते हैं. They are equal in strength and opposite in direction. And we have so many examples to understand this. As you can see in this diagram, a very common observation जो आप करके भी देख सकते हैं, there is a balloon. और जब हम बलून को छोड़ देते हैं तो वो एक गैसेस जो है वो एग्जर्ट करता है डाउनवर्ड. सो दैट इज़ नोन एज द एक्शन. बट टू दैट एक्शन देयर विल बी इक्वल एंड ऑपोजिट रिएक्शन. तो वो रिएक्शन क्या करेगा, बैलून को राइज करने में हेल्प करेगा. दिस इज ऑल्सो यूज इन द फिनोमिना ऑफ रॉकेट प्रोपल्शन. रॉकेट प्रोपल्शन में भी द गैसेज आर रिजेक्टेड डाउनवर्ड, दैट इज एक्शन, एंड द रॉकेट मूव्स अपवर्ड, दैट इज नोन एज रिएक्शन. सम मोर एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ न्यूटन थर्ड लॉ. फर्स्ट इज एज यू कैन सी रिकॉइलिंग ऑफ अ गन. Whenever bullet is fired from the gun, we feel a jerk backward, which is known as recoiling of a gun. Walking on a floor is again an example of Newton's third law. We apply action and in turn we get the reaction as seen in this diagram. Third is when you exert some force on the boat to move forward, reaction is the force exerted backward on the boat. So we have so many examples from our daily life with the help of which you can understand Newton's third law. Now let us discuss about the conservation of momentum. We have read about momentum, and momentum means quantity of motion contained in a body. यानी अगर कोई भी body motion में है तो उसके पास momentum होता है, and you can write momentum as P is equals to mv. Now conservation of momentum says that the momentum of a system always remains constant. किसी भी system का momentum हमेशा constant रहता है, यानी उसकी जो value है वो ना तो बढ़ेगी ना घटेगी. There are certain things in our universe which always remains constant. For example, energy, charge, linear momentum, angular momentum. So we'll write it as if no external force is acting on a system. अगर हम बाहर से कोई भी फोर्स एग्जर्ट ना करें किसी भी सिस्टम पे, तो टोटल मोमेंटम यानी P1 प्लस P2 इज ऑलवेज कांस्टेंट. दिस कैन बी अंडरस्टूड बाय अ सिंपल एग्जांपल ऑफ रिकॉइलिंग ऑफ अ गन. लेट इट बी रिकॉइलिंग ऑफ अ गन, रॉकेट प्रोपल्शन और एक्सप्लोजन ऑफ अ बॉम्ब. सब में हम कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मोमेंटम जो है उसको समझ सकते हैं. सपोज यू हैव दिस एग्जाम्पल. इन दिस केस गन और बुलेट दोनों मिला के एक सिस्टम है. सो यू हैव गन प्लस बुलेट एज अ सिस्टम. इनिशियली बोथ आर एट रेस्ट, तो हम कहेंगे कि इनिशियल मोमेंटम जीरो है, क्योंकि अगर वेलोसिटी नहीं है तो मोमेंटम भी नहीं है. नाउ सपोज बुलेट का मास है स्मॉल m और बुलेट की वेलोसिटी है स्मॉल v. गन का मास है कैपिटल m और गन की वेलोसिटी है कैपिटल v. देन वी एक्सपीरियंस अ जर्क बैकवर्ड विच इज़ नोन एज रिकॉइलिंग ऑफ अ गन, which says that the total momentum mv plus capital mv will always remain constant. yani hum keh sakte hain jiska mass kam hoga usko zyada velocity mil jayegi. yani bullet moves with a very large velocity, but jiska mass zyada hoga yani gun usko ek bahut choti si velocity milti hai jisse wo recoil kar jata hai. तो वेलोसिटी जो है इट विल बी लो वेलोसिटी, और इनिशियल मोमेंटम जीरो था तो इन दोनों का सम भी जीरो होगा. सो दे बोथ मूव इन द ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन, बट इफ़ यू कैलकुलेट तो इन दोनों का सम जो है वो हमेशा हमें जीरो ही मिलेगा. नाउ लेट अस प्रूव दैट द मोमेंटम इज कंजर्वड. सो विल प्रूव द लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मोमेंटम. और फॉर दैट लेट अस कंसिडर कि हमारे पास ये कोई भी बॉडी है जिसका मास है m1, हैविंग वेलोसिटी u1. And it strikes another body having mass m2, having initial velocity u2. Suppose they both collide, and when they collide, their velocities will be changed, and m1 will be having velocity v1, and m2 will be having velocity v2. So the momentum of body A, let them label as ye A body, ye B body. Similarly, this is body A and this is body B. So momentum of body A, or you can write change in momentum of body A, can be written as m1 v1 minus m1 u1. Similarly, change in momentum of body B. Now according to Newton's second law, force acting on body A FA is equal to rate of change of momentum. यानी हम इसको लिख सकते हैं as m1 v1 minus m1 u1 upon change in time, let us consider it to be delta t. Similarly, force acting on body B, m2 v2 minus m1 v1 upon same time interval delta t. Now we can use Newton's third law, and according to third law, forces exerted on both the bodies will be equal and opposite, and to every action there is equal and opposite reaction. So we can equate these two and we can write m1 v1 minus m1 u1 upon delta t is equal to minus m2 v2 minus m2 u2 upon delta t. And also on solving, what we'll get as m1 u1 plus m2 u2 is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. Now what is this? Momentum before collision, and similarly this is momentum after collision, which says that the momentum always remains conserved. Jitna momentum pehle tha, utna hi momentum baad mein hoga. Hence we have proved that the momentum is always conserved. In the next video, we'll discuss concepts related to Newton's laws and numericals related to your chapter Force and Laws of Motion. Thank you.